Okay. You're live.
All right.
Thank you.
Yep.
I Thank you. Thank you. good shot of Randy. Blakely texted me.
Thanks. Anytime. I'm here all night.
Yeah, okay. I'll make sure I move.
Thank you. welcome to our Cancer Awareness Night Match versus the Bold Warriors. The team and I want to say a few things about the importance of cancer awareness and preventive screening, as well as a few things about Lindsay Koenig, fourth grader at Benson Marcel Elementary. I'm going to hand the microphone off to who first? I guess Maddie Schultz went first. Lindsay's the list. Here you go, Maddie. We don't even do this without all the community rallying behind us as it takes a village. Please know she sees, hears, and feels the whole village of Team Blakely's. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts. Keep being brightly like Blakely with all of our love, Danielle, Justin, Cooper, Emma, Kinsley, Whitney, myself, and of course, Miss Blakely. Blakely also says, go Braves and kick some butt, just like she's going to kick her answers named Curly and Swirly's butt.
That happen during a person's lifetime. Factors to reduce the risk of cancer. don't use tobacco, eat a healthy diet, maintain a healthy weight and stay active, protect yourself from the sun, get vaccinated, avoid risky behaviors, get regular medical care. That's only a few. Regular cancer screening is a very important way to prevent cancer. Childhood cancer. About 11,050 children in the United States under the age of 15 will be diagnosed with cancer in 2020. Childhood cancer rates have been rising slightly for the past few decades. Cancer death rates for this age group have declined by 65% from 1970 to 2016. Cancer remains the leading cause of death from disease among children. About 5% of all cancers in children are caused by an inherited mutation, a genetic mutation that can be passed from parents to their children. Because of the major treatment advances in recent decades, 84% of children with cancer now survive 5 years or more. Survival rates can vary a great deal depending on the type of cancer and other factors. Pediatric oncology is a medical specialty focused on the care of children with cancer.
The cancer we decided to talk about is brain and spinal cancer. The ribbon colors are green for brain cancer and gold for spinal cancer. Some facts about spinal cancer are: back pain is the most common early symptom of spinal tumors. Pain might also spread beyond your back and your hips, legs, feet, or arms. Spinal tumors are found on the vertebrae or the spinal cord, whether they are cancerous or non-cancerous. Spine tumors are relatively rare. Only 1 person in 100,000 develops a spine tumor each year. Treatment for a spinal tumor may include surgery, radiation therapy, chemotherapy, or other medications. Some facts about brain cancer are: an estimated 700,000 people are living with a brain tumor in America, 69.8 are benign or non-cancerous, and 30.2 are malignant or cancerous. The chance of a person developing a malignant brain tumor is less than 1%. The risk of developing a brain tumor is slightly higher in men than women. At this time, there is no test recommended for early screening of brain cancer, but MRIs are the most common tests used to find tumors.
Leukemia is a cancer of blood-forming tissues such as bone marrow. It is found among children and adults, and is most common in people over 55. There are two main kinds of leukemia: acute and chronic leukemia.
There are many treatments such as chemotherapy, biological therapy, targeted therapy, radiation therapy, and stem cell transplants. Early detection is possible with merely physical exams, blood tests, and monitoring of any significant symptoms. There is about a 61.4% survival rate of leukemia. The ribbon color is orange and it is recognized in the month of September.
Most cases of thyroid cancer can be found in early and treated successfully. Early thyroid cancers are found when patients see their doctors because of neck lumps or swelling in the neck. Sometimes it is found during a routine checkup and image testing, like ultrasound or CT scans. There are blood tests and thyroid ultrasounds that can find early changes in the thyroid. For those who have family history, they might have a very high risk for developing this cancer. It is highly recommended to get genetic testing for these people when they are young to see if they carry genes that change the elements of this cancer.
Breast cancer is the second most common cancer found in women. Approximately 1 out of every 8 women in the United States will develop invasive breast cancer. The risk increases to about 3 times as likely if they have more than one relative in a close family group with breast cancer. However, most women who develop breast cancer don't have any family history at all. Breast cancer is obviously common enough to cause concern, but early detection can tip the scales in favor of a positive outcome. Early signs of breast cancer may include change of breast size or shape, gain of redness around the breast, or lumps may be felt or even visible in the breast or underarm area. Just because you have these symptoms doesn't mean you have breast cancer. One of the best ways to find breast cancer early is to have a mammogram done. Luckily, our hospital here in Benson offers this to our community. Normally, women start to get mammograms around the age of 40, but if you are having any of the symptoms listed earlier, don't be afraid to get a mammogram done early.
September is Ovarian Cancer Awareness Month, and the main color is teal. Ovarian cancer is more rare. Usually there are
found in women usually ages 41 to 60 and older. Symptoms to look out for are weight loss, discomfort in the pelvic area, and the frequent need to use the restroom. Most women with stage 2 ovarian cancer have a 70% 5-year survival rate, and stage 1 has a 90% survival rate. Make an appointment with your doctor if you know of any family history or have any signs that worry you.
Thank you. You wanna waste time, you waste your time. Good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, we welcome you to the West Central matchup between the visiting Bold Warriors and your hometown, Benson Braves. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand and address our American flag in a proper manner as the Benson Pep Band, under the direction of Mr. Brock Duncan, plays our national anthem.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Michael Bolte, but they're going to say, great game. Let's give Bolte a seat. A great round of applause. Good luck the rest of the way through.